Hi guys, today I have something really special planned for you. Remember Venus from our very, very first show, the girl that was communicating to the elephant?
I do need help with my stomach though.
And then 2 weeks later, I went to revisit the elephant and the vet was just there and actually was examining the elephant because she had serious problems with her digestion.
What did doctor say?
Venus doesn't just communicate with animals. She communicates with people and beings on a whole different level, like beyond language, on an energy level. She does energy healing, she does Reiki, she does seminars with abused kids to help them gain their self-respect again. She helps and works with old and young, rich and poor, and she just has all this love and all the skill and all the spirituality to help other people on a different level, and she kind of dedicated her life to do this. Today we're actually going on a little adventure together. We're going up to the Big Buddha, that's a famous monument up on a mountain here in Phuket. And after that comes something a little bit harder for Venus and I, because we're both kind of tough women and we know what we want in life. And with that comes, you have a little bit of a hard time letting a man take over and lead you. So what would be harder for us than going to a dancing lesson like salsa and letting a man try to teach us dance salsa? I tried it once in Brazil and it was horrible, and I thought I'm never gonna try it again. I felt so stupid and everybody was doing it and it looked so simple and I just couldn't figure it out. It's very important to sometimes push your boundaries when you know you're not good in something or you're really having an issue with this, like to kind of really go and try it again and try it again until it's not an issue anymore. Like maybe you're not skilled in it, but at least get over that, like, oh, I'm never good in this, I cannot do this. And then you get better and better in everything and you know what you can do, what you not can do. And I think that's a good way to kind of go through life, at least for me. Maybe it will work for you too.
Welcome to the Big Buddha.
You have to go on your knees, rub with your knees to him, and he hits you in the head. Hello, kitty.
Remember you, you like. See?
Tuesday, right?
Tuesday
Buddha.
Oh, wow.
That's where they're usually sitting, but they're in the parking lot today.
Interesting. Yeah.
I want to read you something that I wrote. It's a book that I'm writing. It's called Dear Divine, and it's a book of prayers and meditations. So I'd love to share one with you.
Fade to black.
Loving what is. Dear Divine, love is not what I once thought it was. In fact, it is in nowhere near the same galaxy as that. The version of love which caused my life to go into a tailspin and crash into an island where it felt like I was the only one left on Earth was never a true representation of what I now know love to be. Love only came after I truly found that the love I wanted from someone else must first come from a very deep place within. I now tap into that limitless source of healing, creativity, and grand exposure to all that is. It is quiet here, without the chatter of expectation, without the pesky petition to prove that I need any revolutions or planets to turn in order for me to simply be with it. It is my oldest friend. It is the deep breath that carries life into my spiritual organs and brings about every type of external change I could dream of and beyond. It is with this energy that I make this promise to myself today. I promise to love you, to love all of you. I will repeat this declaration until I shift into an even higher vibration of receiving. Loving me is sending the message to my universe that I am worthy, capable, and ready to experience love in all I choose to soak my attentions in. The consequence of living in a loving state is forgiveness, and in forgiveness, the ultimate release. Release creates space, space creates lightness, and from there peace can guide our hearts and actions unhindered. We are grand representations of this divine formula. I am nothing but this electric potential, multidimensional, and moving into the ultrasound of extreme presence, coming alive each moment. Loving without expectation is living with the intent to perceive greatness in each possibility, and choosing from my highest joy brings even more of it into the light. I love so that I may breathe these inevitable blessings into my own being right now. I join back in with my friends of the light and bow in deep reverence to the unhurried comfort of loving what is.
All the monks are coming.
Who's coming?
The monks are coming.
I spent a lot of time in temples in Korea, actually, and I found it very, very comforting. I was actually in a temple the day that I found out my father died, and I'm very, very grateful I was in a temple at that time. Just, yeah, it seemed sort of surreal, but more real, and I was very present, and it was hard to be too upset. It was more acceptance. So I am grateful. I found messengers come in all forms, right? Doesn't matter what religion they are or what particular belief they buy into. Messengers can come from all sorts of angles, if you're open to it. So if I said, oh, I'm only this, then I wouldn't be able to receive from many different types of religions or belief systems, and I think that would be pretty limiting. I don't think I'd be who I am today if I wasn't open-minded enough to listen to the pastor, listen to the monk, you know, listen to the shaman, listen to whatever messenger comes along. So hopefully we're all moving towards more of a unity consciousness where we don't have to hide behind the titles anymore. That'd be cool.
All right, ready? You have something? A little stick?
Well, I'm gonna punch it. That's probably not very Buddhist. Oh, yeah.
Now you.
Come on, harder.
You're on camera. Give me your best. So we're leaving the big Buddha
to go and conquer our fear.
It's gonna be a tough one. The two of us being humble and doing some salsa. Venus and I are at Salsa. We must be at the right spot at the green main. Usually I'm okay in most things that I'm doing, but this thing, dancing and getting led by a man, I'm totally not skilled in. I'm so scared. I never danced before. It's the scariest thing for me in the world. Yeah, honestly. Can you see my nipples? I don't know how to dance. That was great. Not as scary as I thought.
Great teachers, actually. So
makes it so much easier to have a good teacher, huh?
Yeah, and they looked awesome when they were dancing too. So it's very inspiring. Amazing. How about you? Is it? How was it?
I really thought I'm gonna throw a tantrum. I'm gonna freak out. Yeah, and it was amazing.
Yeah, fine. Like it's our first time, really.
Yeah. 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 So, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now we're going. Okay. This was an awesome day. Thank you so much, my goddess.
Love you. Thank you.
Look, we made it. I just know a little bit about you and your magical powers, but I would really like to know more about it. Like, the first thing is, like, did it kind of gradually happen, or did you kind of suddenly fall down the rabbit hole?
Okay, first of all, I think everybody has it.
That's what I thought too.
Yes.
Yes, you're back.
Okay.
Yeah, I think everybody's got it. No, I don't think. I know everybody has it. It's just a matter of, well, ambition. Do you want to tap in? Do you want to know what else is there, what else is possible? Or are you cool with, you know, the status quo of
following the
just
masses.
Going along. Yeah, it depends on what you want. Yeah. For me, it started off more with resistance. I didn't want to know about it. My father was, he was psychic, and he, it was the way he used it that didn't really jam with me. I didn't like it.
Didn't jam with you?
Didn't jam. And my mother also too, she had always had this uncanny ability to sense spirits or to sense if there were other energies in houses or spaces. And him and her together, they, I heard stories from him that they would practice certain things like astral travel or...
Astral travel?
So out-of-body experiences, leaving your body. I don't want to see ghosts. I don't want to know people's future. Just it's like I put a big metal cap on my awareness. And
how old were you then?
Would have been, I don't know, under 10 for sure. I learned a lot of different things to get me to a more original place for myself. So it became my own thing after going through different modalities or different types of energy healing or schools of thought. And it was all just to open myself up to a greater awareness. That's all. And now whatever I do has a common focus. And that focus is to get people to remember that divine spark that they have within themselves, whether that's through some sort of movement, through meditation, through coaching, whatever it takes to get them to tune back in again. To me, everything comes back down to your connection with yourself and your higher self or your source or your God or your goddess or whoever it may be, and how to get back into touch with that so that all these other things aren't really of concern to you. You can, all of the challenges become ease and joy, even the challenges. So it's about giving them tools in whatever manner so that they can facilitate themselves out. And how I am happy is looking for happiness and leaning towards happiness and purposely noticing what things in my life are working for me. And one other thing too is to help other people. I feel like it, especially it's the opposite of what you might think when you're unhappy. Go out into the world and actually just help somebody. And that tends to like raise your own personal vibration. You feel like, oh, right, it's not just about me and my little problem that I think that I have.
Exactly.
Just open out the viewfinder a little bit and go, oh, yeah, okay, that felt good. I'm kind of over myself now. That wasn't such a big deal after all, and you kind of can have a little bit of a laugh at yourself. So I get a lot of messages from people who allow themselves to get sucked in by those negative thoughts that creep in. And I mean, I've been there too, you know. I've allowed that to take over my whole day, my whole week, my whole relationship. I have bad days too. Some people seem to Yeah, that's it. No, but people don't think that I actually feel anything apart from wee, you know. I wasn't always like that. And I think I'm catching up with myself now. I often just say, ask them, like, are you willing to change? Is happiness something that you actually want to have? Or are you enjoying being in this dark place? Because if you are, by all means, go ahead. Just don't pretend.
Nobody is. Nobody wants to be.
Some people, I don't know. Really? I feel like some people really want to be. And or even it's just a period of time. So being in that fully and allowing yourself to feel really crappy, maybe that's exactly what you need at that time. So not to resist it, and it will pass faster. Okay. So it depends on where you are.
How it happened.
Yeah.
So you cannot like use your own advice. You can heal other people. Can you heal yourself?
I think I actually have done a lot of work on myself, and that's why I'm able to share the information that I have without sounding like a fake. Because if I hadn't have gone through that, I feel like I would sound not true, not genuine. So having taken myself through things and learned stuff obsessively to get myself over it, I guess that's what you mean by healing, is letting go and releasing and becoming a new version and upgrading and repeat.
Okay.
You know, so
you
got to get yourself first, right? It's all about loving yourself first.
Yeah. I kind of noticed like spiritual people, they really take care of their body. They don't even listen to bad music. They don't even listen to the news or watch horror movies. Do you?
Same.
Do you do the same, right?
Yeah, there was a woman that I live with, and she told me that what you put around you is creating an energy around you. And she actually took pictures off my wall of some things that I had up there. And it was the first time anyone had ever spoken to me quite like that. And it made me think, huh, okay, this is creating a specific energy, these types of books, this type of music, these types of clips of these movies, and that's all coming together to create its own energy. And so now I'm more selective about what nurtures me in my space and my environment, and I am pretty selective, and that includes people.
It's the end of the beginning of the end.